Engineers use reverb as an artistic effect. It can be used to fill gaps between sounds and make mixes more harmonically rich. It can also be used to hide imperfections such as noise or edits, as the reverb tail does a great job of covering quiet mistakes that may have otherwise poked through. Reverb also has several sonic benefits. It can provide instruments or groups of instruments with a sense of distance, creating the illusion that sources are further away from the listener in the sound field. Dense early reflections improve pitch perception and detail, because the listener's ears integrate these reflections into the original sound. There are multiple ways to generate a reverb effect. Historically, echo chambers were built to send a dry signal into a speaker-microphone arrangement and capture the sound of the reflections in the room. These could then be blended with a dry signal, creating a reverb effect. Electromechanical devices such as plates and spring reverbs made their way into studios in the 1950s. In these units, a transducer vibrated a steel plate or spring and recaptured the resulting sound with a pickup. These saved space over the echo chamber and introduced their own characteristic sounds. The final stage of evolution was the digital reverb, which can take many forms, including a plugin. But the techniques of using reverb are basically the same, whether you use an echo chamber, plate reverb, or a digital plugin. I'm going to demonstrate how to use reverb in Mixbus using Gverb Plus. This plugin is available as part of our Plugin Essentials pack. If we know that we want reverb on a particular instrument, we can add it directly to the track. From here, we can select our preset. Presets can range from realistic spaces such as a small room to effects that do not exist in the real world.
I don't mind if there's cloudy weather, if it rains sometimes, as long as we're together. I don't mind putting on a sweater when I'm going out with you. Even if the streets are wet and puddly, even if my shoes get soaked and muddy, 'cause whenever we're together, chases away the cloudy weather. I'm happy to be out with you.
Early reflections define the room shape and tend to make the reverb sound more realistic. The reverb tail is a wash of dense reflections that provide a flattering but less realistic effect. With the plugin on a single track, we can use the wet-dry blend to adjust the amount of reverb. Bussing multiple tracks into the same reverb is a common practice. It helps instruments to have a more realistic gel and to sound as though they were recorded in the same room. This technique is typically used on dry recorded tracks. If you plan to use artificial reverb in your mix, it's a good idea to record elements using both close miking and direct input methods as much as possible. To apply this technique to our mix, we can use one of the 8 mix buses to add an instance of Gverb Plus, and then send all of our desired instruments into it. This creates a much more natural and cohesive effect than inserting a reverb on each individual track. All of our mix elements will now sound as if they originated in the same space. After we've selected a preset, we want to make sure the mix knob is set to produce a 100% wet signal. We do this so we can then use the send knobs on our individual tracks as a dry-wet control. The more signal we send to the Mixbus, the wetter it becomes. This makes it really easy for us to build a 3D space. I can simply add more reverb to the tracks that I would like to place farther away in the sound field, and vice versa.
I won't mind when gray skies are approaching. Mind up for you, needs no extra coaching. I won't hide if the storm is forecast. It won't change my point of view. I won't see a gray cloud as cause of agony. Won't let raindrops deprive me of your company. Cause the day seems sunny when I spend it with my honey.
Classic tracks often have a lot of reverb, while modern productions use relatively little. If you want a vintage sound, you should consider using more reverb in your mix. At times, we may want certain tracks to sit more up front in the mix, while still retaining a reverberant sound. This is typically the case with lead vocals. Here's a way to visualize the effect of pre-delay. When the listener, in this case our microphone, is placed far from the source, the reverberant sound comes in slightly after the initial sound. As you add more pre-delay, the reflections begin to arrive much later than the direct signal. This gives the perception that the singer is closer to the listener. In this example, I will use another Mixbus to create a duplicate of my session reverb and name it Vocal Reverb. After sending the vocal to the appropriate Mixbus, I can now adjust the pre-delay to help my vocal stand out and be more forward in the mix. Adding pre-delay also lessens the comb filtering that happens when you add short delays to the singer. A little bit here goes a long way. Be careful. Too much pre-delay can separate the source from its reverb tail.
I don't mind if there's cloudy weather, if it rains sometimes, as long as we're together.
Another common technique is to use two different reverbs in your mix, typically a short plate-like sound and a longer hall-like sound. By sending different tracks to these different reverbs, or to both simultaneously, you can create a more interesting and three-dimensional mix. If the goal is to make your mix spacey and affected, we can introduce additional processing with the reverb. In this case, I'm adding a chorus before the reverb to add some additional motion. By applying it to the reverb but not the original sound, We get the motion of the chorus while still retaining the clarity in the vocal. Here's one last thing to keep in mind. Since reverb occupies many of the same areas in the frequency spectrum as our mix elements, we may find ourselves needing to cut from the mid-range and lows in our aux channel to retain clarity. We can insert a more expanded EQ before or after the reverb should we need more flexibility.